Sup? What's lit, fam? We're just lounging, you know, we're keeping it casual. It's gonna be a fun time. We're gonna dive right into questions. If you could be a pizza, what kind of pizza would you be? I was challenged to answer this question while eating a pizza. If I was a pizza, I would be an extra cheesy pizza Lunchable. Maybe you think that's weird. I'm answering this question first because I'm hungry. Come on up. He really likes cheese. Because they are small and mostly just kids like them. So I think that's me as a pizza. Wants attention and cheese. Somebody asked me when I was gonna go to Australia. So I answered it by doing this. Unfortunately, I don't have any plans to go to Australia soon, but I am in Sydney, Ohio. And here's my dance. I'm performing for you. Hey! Hey! Will you come to Nashville next year and do a live sessions at Sanctuary Sessions? Yeah, if I'm invited. You can't just invite yourself to that kind of party, you know, so, like, invite me. Rub your head and pat your belly while describing the story of how you got your band name. So, the project is named after this awesome woman named Betty Jones, the original Jetty Bones. She was one of the coolest people I've ever met. Really, oh, that's hard. Really inspiring. Anyways, maybe ask me in person and I'll tell you all about it. Somebody asked me what my favorite restaurant in Columbus is. So a lot of people that I know in real life, friends, coworkers, children, have gathered by the various times that I've started a slow chant to try to persuade people into going to this restaurant that my favorite restaurant in Columbus is indeed Dirty Franks. Dirty Franks, say it with me, Dirty Franks. See, I'm the only person here, but that's generally about as effective as my slow chant is in real life, too. Anyways, moving on. If you could collaborate with any artist, who would it be? Andy Hall. Don't even have to think about it. Somebody asked me how long I've had my son. You've never met my son. This is him. His name is Albie. He's an albino cat, and he loves cheese. I adopted him in the fall 2 years ago. From an animal shelter, and I love him.
Albie is a baby. Little baby Albie with some cheese.
I have always liked cats, yes. This cat is like my soulmate pet. See? Moving on. If you could tour with four bands, who would they be? Build your lineup. There are way too many bands that I like. Lineup number one would be this. Tiny Moving Parts, Manchester Orchestra, Free Throw, The Menzingers. Kind of like a cross-genre band, so, you know. Finishing my pizza. Moving onward.
That was good.
What's your favorite cereal? What are your thoughts on chocolate milk? Can you twiddle your thumbs in two different directions at the same time? And can you do the Macarena without singing the song? So, first and foremost, not a big cereal person. It's like cold soup, or like a granola straight from the bag with my hand, put it in my mouth, crunch, crunch, eat it down, it's good to go. I don't like chocolate. As for your other questions, Quinn, you wanna do the Macarena? Okay, here we go. Your favorite book? You seem like quite the intellectual. Since you put it that way, my favorite book is Diary, which, as you can see, is a novel by Chuck Palahniuk. It's funny how you can have a favorite author and still get really insecure anytime you try to pronounce his last name because everyone says it differently. I had a lot of people asking about makeup tutorials, tips, what kind of glitter do I use, blah 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 blah, which I totally plan on doing in the future. A lot of those questions are prompted by the fact that I douse myself in beautiful glamorous glitter, which I do, but we'll get into that in that video. Can you heel click and kiss yourself in the face? So there are your results for that. However, the first time I read that, I read it as you wanting me to kick myself in the face. Doing so is a skill. It is a skill, one that I do not have. Is this too casual? What are your inspirations, and do you have any plans to tour to Florida soon? I don't know when I'm going anywhere else yet, but all of that will be posted on social media as soon as I know. As far as my inspiration goes, this is kind of a more detailed thing. I could probably spend a whole video talking about it. I started writing because it was something that helped me make sense of the very confusing things that were going on inside of my head. And I realized when I was in my first band that by performing those and giving those to people and making it about way more than yourself, you have an opportunity to connect with people on a level that is so genuine and so good that that's kind of what kept me going for a really long time. And I know a lot of people say this, but anytime I play a show and someone comes up to me and says, hey, this song helped me through this, or I really connected with this line in this song, that's it. That's all that I need, even if it's just one person in a room full of 1,000, that one person is the reason that I'm there. A lot of people would probably think the one person that I'm there for is myself, but that's not it. That's not it for me. Whoa, I forgot to make an outro, so thanks for tuning in. There's gonna be some more new stuff posted online soon, and outros are even worse than intros, so if you are nervous, you should just sing a song, because everybody feels better when you're singing, and I guess I'm just gonna get out of here now. I didn't mean to show you who I really am. I just did that. I didn't mean to. I didn't mean to do that.